The ride Judah. Yeah. Righteous in my actions, no distractions. Breaking scriptures down to a fraction. Sabbath day relaxing, on the streets blasting. Scriptures keep slashing while Christians keep dashing. Christ was a black man, but they hate me for my black skin. Thought you
Officer
knew Christ,
dies,
you really need some madness.
All right, today's lesson is entitled Suicidal Thoughts and Depression. All right, this is something that our people struggle with. They may not admit to it, but this is something our people face. To start us off, give me Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 13.
Ecclesiastes chapter 12 and verse 13.
Mm-hmm.
Let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commands. For this is the whole duty of man.
All right, this is the whole duty of man. All right, so it doesn't matter what you're going through. All right, keep it simple. Keep God's commandments, and that's it. All right, give me 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. All right, because you have to understand, you're not the only person who deals with these things, all right? Give me that.
1 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 13.
Mm-hmm.
They have no temptation taking you, but such as is common to man.
Common to man. So if you're dealing with it, somebody else has already dealt with it. Read on.
But God is faithful,
mm-hmm.
who will not suffer you to be tempted above that ye are able.
So if this is something that you're struggling with, the Most High already knows you can overcome it. All right? Read on.
But will with the temptation also make a way to escape,
mm-hmm.
that ye may be able to bear.
That ye may be able to bear. Give me Sirach chapter 40, verse 1. All right? Because everybody likes to throw pity parties and say, like, you don't know what I'm going through. All of this. All right? So let's see what this says right here. Give me that.
Sirach chapter 40 and verse 1.
Mm-hmm.
Great travail is created for every man.
For one man.
For every man.
Read on.
And a heavy yoke is upon the sons of Adam.
So we all going to face trials. All right? Read on.
From the day that they go out of their mother womb,
mm-hmm.
till the day that they return to the mother of all things.
Read on.
Their imagination of things to come and the day of death.
Their imagination of things to come and the day of death. That's something that weighs heavy on our people's minds. All right, read on.
Trouble their thoughts and cause fear of heart.
Fear of heart. All right, according to 2 Timothy 1 and 7, fear is not of the Most High God.
Right.
All right, so what is this telling us? You will be tempted of the devil throughout your lifetime. All right, read on.
From him that sitteth on a throne of glory, unto him that is humbled in earth and ashes, from him that weareth purple, and a crown unto him that is clothed with a linen frock.
So it's saying from the lowly all the way up to the people who are rich. Everybody's going through something, okay? Read on.
Wrath and envy, trouble and unquietness, fear of death.
Fear of what?
Fear of death.
Fear of death. A lot of people are scared to die, all right? But now, if you're a repentant Israelite, that shouldn't be in your mind, okay? Because we know that the Most High God, he glorifies in the death of his saints, all right? Give me that. I mean, I'm sorry, don't give me that, but read on.
And anger, and strife, and in the time of rest, upon his bed, his night sleep, do change his knowledge.
Do change his knowledge, all right? Do change the way he thinks about things. Read on.
A little or nothing is his rest, and afterward he is in his sleep, as in a day of keeping watch, troubled in the vision of his heart, as if he were escaped out of a battle.
So these type of thoughts can even plague you in your dreams, all right? And a lot of them do, even me. I have dreams like this, okay? Read on.
When all is safe, when he awaketh and marveleth that the fear was nothing.
That the fear was nothing. It was all a dream. It was nothing but wicked thoughts, all right? Read.
Such things happen unto all flesh.
How many people?
All flesh.
All flesh. Everybody goes through this. Read on.
Both man and beast,
uh-huh.
and that is sevenfold more upon sinners.
But it's worse for sinners, okay? That's why you see a lot of these celebrities turn to drugs,
right.
All right? Because they can't take it. From there, give me Acts 10 and 38. All right. Acts 10, chapter 38.
Acts chapter 10 and verse 38.
Uh-huh.
How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil.
Read.
For God was with him.
All right, so it's not that you can't get over this, okay? The Most High can heal you that who's being affected, hearing thoughts, hearing voices, all of that. Okay, read it again.
Acts chapter 10, verse 38.
Mm-hmm.
How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power, who went about doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil.
Healing all that were oppressed of the devil. In order to be healed, you must believe. Give me that, Sirach 32 and 24. So if you're not keeping God's commandments, not firmly believing in the Most High, it's not going to work. It's not going to work for you. Give me that.
Sirach chapter 32, verse 24. Mm-hmm. He that believeth in the Lord taketh heed to the commandments.
So you have to put in work. All right, you have to pray. You have to fast to get the devil off of you. From there, give me Romans 15 and 4. So we just read in the scriptures that if you are diligently seeking the Most High, all right, doing what He say do, you can be healed of this, okay? But this Bible is to show us the good and the bad. We're supposed to learn from our forefathers, all right? Give me that.
For whatsoever things were written aforetime, mm-hmm, were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope.
All right, so we're going to go to a story of one of our forefathers who actually did end up committing suicide, okay? But we're going to show you why he did it, because his heart was heavy. He did not lean to the Most High God in the time of trouble. All right, give me 1 Samuel chapter 9 and 15. All right, so we just read in, Acts chapter 10, verse 38, that if you believe, all right, the Most High God, He'll heal you, all right? But let's read this story real quick.
1 Samuel chapter 9 and verse 15.
Mm-hmm.
Now the Lord had told Samuel in his ear a day before Saul came, saying, tomorrow about this time I will send thee a man out of the land of Benjamin, and thou shalt anoint him to be captain over my people Israel,
mm-hmm,
that he may save my people out of the land of the Philistines. For I have looked upon my people, because their cries come unto me.
Read on.
And when Samuel saw Saul, the Lord said unto him, behold, the man whom I spake to thee of, this same shall reign over my people.
So this is talking about King Saul, okay? He was the first king over Israel, okay? Jump up to chapter 16 and verse 13. So we're gonna jump across. So he was the first king of Israel, and he did wickedness in the sight of the Most High God. All right, read this.
1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 13.
Mm-hmm.
Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brother. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David.
So now David, now he's getting the Spirit of the Lord because he's next in line. Read on.
From that day forward, so Samuel rose up and went to Ramah. But the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul.
But now the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul because he did wickedness. Read on.
And an evil spirit from the Lord troubled him.
Uh-huh.
And Saul's servant said unto him, behold now, an evil spirit from God troubleth thee.
So now, from this point on, he was getting troubled with the wicked spirit. Okay? From there, jump up to chapter 19 and verse 8.
1 Samuel chapter 19 and verse 8.
Mm-hmm.
And there was war again. And David went out and fought with the Philistines, and slew them with a great slaughter, and they fled from him. And the evil spirit from the Lord was upon Saul.
So the evil spirit kept coming and going, read on.
As he sat in his house with his javelin in his hand.
So he had a javelin in his hand waiting on David to slay him, read on.
And David played with his hand. And Saul sought to smite David even to the wall with the javelin.
Mm-hmm.
But he slipped away out of Saul's presence. And he smote the javelin into the wall. And David fled and escaped that night.
So this wicked spirit is on King Saul so bad that he's trying to kill his own brother. All right. Jump up to chapter 28 and start at verse 3.
1 Samuel chapter 28 and verse 3.
Mm-hmm.
Now Samuel was dead, and all Israel had lamented him and buried him in Ramah, even in his own city. And Saul had put away those that had familiar spirits and the wizards out of the land.
Read on.
And the Philistines gathered themselves together and came and pitched in Shunem. And Saul gathered all Israel together, and they pitched in Gilboa. And when Saul saw the host of the Philistines, he was afraid, and his heart greatly trembled.
So now he has fear in him. The Most High God ain't dealing with him no more. So now he has a spirit of fear. Read on.
And when Saul inquired of the Lord answered him not,
uh-huh,
neither by dreams, nor by Urim, nor by prophets.
Read verse 7.
Then said Saul unto his servants, seek me a woman that hath a familiar spirit.
So now he's going off. Instead of seeking continually to go on a fast, pray to the Most High, all right, coming with him in a contrite heart, now he's turning to the devil,
right.
All right? Instead of seeking the Most High in a time of trouble, he's going with the devil. All right, read on. Read that again, verse 7.
Verse 7. Then said Saul unto his servants, seek me a woman that hath a familiar spirit, that I may go to her and inquire of her.
Mm-hmm.
And his servant said to him, behold, there is a woman that hath a familiar spirit at Endor.
All right, so right there, that's his mistake. One, I'm going to start at verse 1.
1 Samuel chapter 31 and verse 1. Now the Philistines fought against Israel, and the men of Israel fled from before the Philistines, and fell down slain in Mount Gilboa. And the Philistines followed hard upon Saul and upon his sons. And the Philistines slew Jonathan and Abinadab and Melechath, Saul's sons. And the battle went sore against Saul.
Mm-hmm.
And the archers hit him, and he was sore wounded of the archers.
Verse 4.
Then said Saul unto his armor bearer, draw thy sword and thrust me through therewith, lest these uncircumcised come and thrust me through and abuse me. But his armor bearer would not, for he was sore afraid. Therefore Saul took a sword and fell upon him.
So Saul killed himself, all right, because of fear. But give me Joshua 23:6.
All right.
I'm sorry, 23:10. His problem is that instead of doing what he's supposed to do, get right, all right, he went to the familiar spirit. Now he has a spirit of fear because he's not doing what the Most High God asked him to do. But he forgot about this right here.
Joshua chapter 23, verse 10.
Mm-hmm.
One man of you shall chase 1,000, for the Lord your God, he it is that fighteth for you.
Who fights for us?
For the Lord your God, he it is that fighteth for you.
So that's where he messed up, because he wasn't right. The Most High God wasn't with him anymore. So he had to act out of fear and ended up killing himself. Now go back to read verse 5. I want you to read this. It was very important. To anybody, you know, battling this type of spirit, you have to realize people look up to you. You somebody's brother, you somebody's sister. Okay? Read verse 5.
And 1 Samuel?
Yes, sir.
1 Samuel chapter 31 and verse 5.
Mm-hmm.
And when his armor bearer saw that Saul was dead, he fell likewise upon his sword and died with him.
So you see that? He looked up to Saul. He looked up to Saul, somebody mighty, but he seen him go out like a coward. What did he do? He did the same thing. Alright? So we gotta shake off that type of spirit, Israel. Alright, from there, go to Sirach chapter 4, verse 3. So when you are going through hard times, you make sure you get into a good place. Surround yourself with righteous people. Alright?
Sirach chapter 4, verse 3.
Mm-hmm.
Add no more trouble to a heart that is vexed.
So if you're already going through something, don't make it worse. Okay? Read that again.
Add no more trouble to an heart that is vexed.
Read on.
And defer not to give to him that is in need.
From there, give me Sirach 30 and 21. Sirach chapter 30, verse 21.
All right.
Sirach, read that.
Chapter 30 and verse 21.
Mm-hmm.
Give not over thy mind to heaven.
Give not over thy mind to what?
Give not over thy mind to heaven.
Read on.
And afflict not thyself in thine own counsel.
So that's why you have to surround yourself with righteous individuals, because your own counsel is always going to lead you wrong. All right? Because you're giving place to the devil. From there, give me 2 Ezra chapter 15, and we'll start at verse 3. 15 and
3.
2
Ezra 15 and
3. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All right? Because it's not just situations that come across. It could be people that are close to you, all right? Because a lot of people, if somebody that you esteem highly says something to you, all right, and you respect them, that may put you in a depressed state, all right? Give me that.
2 Ezra chapter 15 and verse 3.
Mm-hmm.
Fear not the imaginations against thee. Let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee.
So if somebody's speaking against you, don't let that get your spirits low. So bad till you get into a depressed state,
right.
Okay? From there, give me 2 Ezra chapter 2 verse 27. Alright, now this scripture right here ties into what Saul should have did. Alright, in a time of trouble. This is what he should have done.
2 Ezra chapter 2 and verse 27.
Uh-huh.
Be not weary.
Be not what?
Be not weary.
Uh-huh.
For when the day of trouble and heaviness cometh, others shall weep and be sorry.
So other people who are not rooted in these scriptures, now they, yeah, that's gonna be hard on them because they don't know where their power is. Okay, read on.
But thou shalt be merry and have abundance.
And have abundance in that day, okay? Because we're the Israelites, we know who our God is.
Right.
Okay, from there, give me Proverbs chapter 12 and verse 25. All right. 12 and 25. Read that.
Proverbs chapter 12 and verse 25.
Mm-hmm.
Heaviness in the heart of a man maketh it stoop.
So if you allow yourself to get overcome with this sorrow, this heaviness, you're going to be in a bad mood. You're going to be all mopey. Like, what's wrong with you, brother? Oh, nothing. But you don't want to get over it. Read it again.
Heaviness in the heart of a man maketh it stoop.
Maketh it stoop. Read on.
But a good word maketh it glad.
But a good word maketh it glad. How are you going to hear that good word? You just going to hear it? You just sitting there? Or you got to be around somebody that has the scriptures to uplift your spirits. From there. Give me Sirach 13 and 25.
All right. Yeah, can I ask
you? Yeah, go ahead.
All right. Proverbs chapter 17 and verse 23.
I'll read it.
22. Proverbs 17 and 22.
Proverbs chapter 17, verse 22.
Mm-hmm.
A merry heart doeth good like a medicine.
Like what?
Like a medicine.
You see that? A merry heart. That person that's not always down, always sad. It said to do it good like a medicine. Read.
But a broken spirit drieth the bones.
You see that? We can't have that broken spirit that the brother's talking about. You can't have that scary, that fearful spirit. It says it dries the bone. And eventually you'll make decisions that aren't right. All right, where do you want me to go?
Sirach chapter 13, verse 25.
Sirach chapter 13 and verse 25. Mm-hmm. The heart of a man changeth his countenance.
The heart of a man changeth his countenance, just like we read in it was Proverbs 17 and 22. Read that again.
The heart of a man changeth his countenance.
Uh-huh.
Whether it be for good or evil.
And we read that in Proverbs 12 and 25, because if you got the heaviness on you, your countenance, you're gonna be all sad. Your demeanor is gonna kill any presence that you in, put everybody else in a lowly type of spirit as well. But on the flip side, if you're in a merry spirit, your countenance is gonna show that as well. Right. Read that all the way through for me.
The heart of a man changes his countenance, whether it be for good or evil.
Uh-huh.
And a merry heart maketh a cheerful countenance.
And a merry heart maketh a cheerful countenance, okay? But jump up in the chapter. Give me verse 16.
Verse 16. All flesh consorted according to kind.
So all flesh. If you want to be in that state, if you want to stay like that, you're going to stay around people like that, okay? Read it again.
All flesh concerted according to kind.
Read on.
And a man will cleave to his life.
To his life. So if you sincerely want to overcome this struggle, you need to cleave to righteous individuals who are in good moods.
Right.
Who are not negative, okay? From there, give me Sirach 39 and 1. All right, because it's all about your mindset. It's either going to give your mind over to heaviness or you're going to seek the Most High. Give me that.
Sirach chapter 39 and verse 1.
Uh-huh.
But he that giveth his mind to the law of the Most High,
uh-huh,
and is occupied in the meditation thereof will seek out the wisdom of all the ancient and be occupied in prophecy.
Instead of your mind being occupied in heaviness, it'll be occupied in the prophecies.
Right.
You'll be saying, oh, homosexuality just got passed. Oh, this is spiritually Sodom and Egypt. Instead of saying, dang, man, my mama just died. I think I should need to kill myself. All right? That's the realization. You need to occupy yourself in the laws of the Most High God. All right? Give me Sirach chapter 14, verse 20. All right? And yeah, there we go.
That's Sirach. Chapter 14 and verse 20.
Mm-hmm.
Blessed is the man that doth meditate good things in wisdom.
So that's when good things are going to happen to you. Blessed is the man who meditate on this wisdom. Read on.
And that reasoneth of holy things by his understanding.
Not by carnal things. Not by how am I going to get out of this situation. How am I going to pay my rent. Dang, I hope my baby mama get back with me. Stuff like that. All right, but you're reasoning with understanding. You're going to say, I don't care. The Most High God's going to provide it for me as long as I keep his commandments.
Alright?
From there, give me Philippians chapter 4 and verse 6. Alright? Philippians chapter 4 and verse 6. We read down a little bit.
Gotcha. Philippians chapter 4 and verse 6.
Mm-hmm.
Be careful for nothing.
So, don't care about anything. Why? Because it's your Father that provides for you. Read on.
But in everything, by prayer and supplication. When thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God.
So if you do struggle with certain things, if your heart is weary over how your relationships are going or how you're going to pay your bills, go to the Most High for that thing. All right? Don't put that self on you.
And the peace of God.
The what?
And the peace of God.
It says if you do that, the peace of God, read on,
passeth all understanding.
It says, which passeth all understanding. So the cares, the carnal cares of man, you're going to be like, oh, I'm good. The contrary part is going to be like, how in the world are you able to keep your cool in this situation?
Right.
All
right,
read that again.
And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus.
That's how you're going to keep your sanity, okay? Not worrying about things of this world. I got a coworker. Mm-hmm. All right, I work in customer service. She's always like, how are you able to keep your cool when you got all these customers cussing you out? You got all of this going on. I'm like, I don't care. She's like, what do you mean you don't care? Like, you do a great job. Like, what do you mean? Okay, I don't care. I don't let it get to me. You feel what I'm saying? Because The wisdom of this Bible surpasses all the wisdom of the world.
Right.
Okay, that's what you have to understand. You really have to trust. Lay all your cares to the Most High God. All right? Read verse 8, please.
Verse 8. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things.
Think on those things. Don't think about the cares of the world, okay? Think about things that are of profit, of virtue, substance, okay? From there, give me 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 6. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 6. All right, we'll read down on this one as well. All right, give me that.
1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 6.
Mm-hmm.
Humble yourselves, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time.
So if the Most High God has to exalt you in due time, that means there will be a time where everything's not okay. Okay, that's why it says humble yourselves. Prepare thyself for temptation, okay? Read on.
Casting all your care upon him.
Doing what?
Casting all your care upon him.
Read on.
For he cared for you.
For he cared for you. Read on.
Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may desire.
So, be sober. I'm sorry.
As to whom he may devour.
Whom he may devour. All right, so be sober, okay? Be sober. Don't turn to drugs. Don't turn to alcoholism, okay? Don't be caught up in different doctrines, okay? Be caught up in sound doctrine, all right? Be vigilant. Watch and pray. Don't be naive and say like, oh, I can do this. I'll be fine. Even like family members that causes depression on a lot of people. When they come into the truth, they can't take the fact that all of their family now is turned on them. And that may put those type of thoughts in your head. All right, so it says be vigilant as well. Go to Matthew chapter 10. He's gonna tell you that was gonna happen. So don't be naive and not prepare yourself for the fight to come. Read verse 8 again for me.
In verse 8.
Uh-huh.
Be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour.
All right, because if you're not vigilant, the devil's vigilant. He's waiting for you to slip up so he can come attack you, so he can put that wicked thought back in your head all over again. All right, from there, give me Ephesians chapter 6 and 11. You got something?
Yeah, go to 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 16. I mean, verse 3. Because this goes in what you said about work. Some people get depressed about their job. They get depressed about family. All of these things they must come to pass. All right, read that.
2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 3.
Uh-huh.
Thou therefore endure hardness.
Endure what?
Hardness.
Read.
As a good soldier of Jesus Christ.
You got to understand that this world that we're living in is a playing field. This is the war. All right? So we got to endure these things as a good soldier. Read.
No man that warreth entangleth himself with the affairs of this life.
You see that? We can't entangle ourselves with the affairs of this life. So we can't let these things get so much on us that now we want to take our own life away from ourselves. You can't do that. Read.
That he may please him who hath chosen him to be a soldier.
You see that? If you take yourself out of this battle, how are you going to be a good soldier for Christ? All right? Ephesians what?
Ephesians 6, chapter 11. I mean, chapter 6, verse 11.
Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 11. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Which is the wiles of the devil, just like it said in 1 Peter chapter 5. You have to be vigilant, all right? It said put on the whole armor. The whole armor is these laws, is this Bible, all right? Read on.
For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places.
So this is not carnal, all right? This is spiritual. Every last bit of this is spiritual. All right, from there, give me James chapter 4, verse 7. All right, because it takes work. You are not just going to overcome these trials by just sitting there. Right. Give me that.
James chapter 4, verse 7. Submit yourself to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you.
So you must resist the devil, and he may flee for you. So how do you resist the devil? Don't be alone by yourself. All right, don't allow the devil to play on your mind, because that's what he's gonna do. when you're away from your brothers and sisters. All right, let's say you got a day off. You need to reach out to a righteous brother or sister, study, watch videos, okay? These are the things you need to do. You need to fast, you need to pray so you can overcome this. And most importantly, don't give in to those thoughts, right? Because the scripture said, resist the devil and he will flee from you, yep. Okay? Give me Sirach chapter 41 verse 13, okay? Sirach 41 and 13, because the title of the lesson is Suicidal Thoughts and Depression. Give me that.
Sirach chapter 41 and verse 13. A good life have but few days.
A good life. What is good? The law is just and good. So a righteous life is short. That's what it's telling you. Read it again.
A good life have but few days.
Uh-huh.
But a good name endure forever.
So it's appointed for every man to die. What's a good name? Moses, David, Paul, Jesus Christ. They left an example for you to follow. They didn't say, when I'm tempted, let me kill myself. When I'm tempted, let me go cry in the corner. No, they showed the examples. When they faced hard times, they overcame it. They were in prison. They were beat. All of these are examples for us to follow. From there, give me Amos chapter 5, verse 18. All right? Because say you getting those suicidal thoughts in your head, right? And you think about calling it quits, ending your life, right? You have to understand, you gotta face your maker. You gotta face the Most High God. And this scripture right here tells you, don't do that. Give me that.
Amos chapter 5, verse 18.
Mm-hmm.
Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord.
Woe means danger, destruction. It says, woe, hold up. If you're desiring that, you're not in the spirit. Alright? Read that again.
Woe unto you that desire the day of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
To what end is it for you? The day of the Lord is darkness. And not light.
And not light. It's not light. All right. Give me Revelation 20 and 12. I just want to add this before we end this. I want to add this because you have to understand. If you're in it. Now, let me ask you also. See, so if you're in the mindset of wanting to kill yourself.
Right.
How in the world are you even ready for the kingdom of heaven?
Not.
So you putting yourself in a bad predicament if you think about killing yourself.
Right.
And you ain't even overcome nothing while you're here on earth.
Right.
And this is what you're going to be judged on right here. Revelation 20 and 12.
Revelation chapter 20 and verse 12.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw the dead, small and great, stand before God. And the books were open. And another book was opened, which is the book of life. And the dead were judged out of those things which were written in the books, according to their works.
According to their works.
Mm-hmm.
According to your works. Every man will be judged according to his works. So you, that servant who says, times got rough, bang. You're gonna be judged on that. Now tell me this. If I tell my son, right, if I had a son, I tell him, hey, I want you to get straight A's, right? He's in the 11th grade. So he finds out it's hard to get straight A's and he drops out of school. That's telling me he don't have what it takes. That's what it's telling me.
You can't give him that inheritance.
Exactly. I can't give him his savings fund for college.
Yeah.
If the brother's gonna drop out in 11th grade because he can't make straight A's. Y'all have to examine yourself. Y'all gotta realize the Most High God is proving us.
Mm-hmm.
So you wanting to do that, no, that's not of the Most High God. Alright? Alright, you had something?
Yeah. Proverbs 16 and 25.
Alright.
Proverbs 16 and 25. Because at the end of the day, when you get into these thoughts, It's your mind. It's your mind that's telling you these things. When you read Jeremiah 17 and 9, it says the mind is desperately wicked. Who can know? All right, this scripture backs that up. Read that.
Proverbs chapter 16, verse 25.
Uh-huh.
There is a way that seemeth right unto a man.
Read that again.
There is a way that seemeth right unto a man.
So when things are getting hard, all right, it may seem right to go sell drugs. It may seem right to become a whoremonger. It may seem right to be a stripper. Read.
But the end result
of you doing what you think is right, read,
are the ways of death.
You see that? So when you got to make sure everything you do, every decision you make, we must filter it through the scripture, because the ends of doing what you want to do, it will equal death.
Mm-hmm. Give me wisdom, Solomon chapter 3.
All right,
and start at verse 1.
Wisdom of Solomon chapter 3 and verse 1. But the souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and there shall no torment touch them.
So, that should give you peace of mind,
right?
Because it's letting you know, if you righteous, which is Deuteronomy 6:25, keeping God's commandments, if you righteous, you know that no torment is going to come against you, that the Most High God is going to be for you. So why not get through the hard times? Because that's waiting for you. Now, hard times come and you trying to bail out. You don't know what your end is going to be. Give me that in 1 Peter 4:17 before we end it. All right, we gotta go through this. I'm at a few scriptures. Go ahead and give me that first.
1 Peter 4:17.
Uh-huh.
For the time has come that judgment must begin at the house of God. And if it first begin at us, what shall the end of them that obey not the gospel of God?
So what should your end be if you're not going to obey? Keep my commandments and live. Read on.
Verse 18. And if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear?
Where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear? Give me Romans 2:12. All right. So that's the kind of questions you should be asking. All right. Give me that.
Romans 2:12.
Uh-huh.
For as many have sinned without the law shall also perish without the law.
For many as sinned without the law shall also perish without the law. Read.
And as many as have sinned in the law shall be judged by the law.
So if you is in this truth and you are in the law and you decide to, you know, and you decide to do that, that's what you're going to be judged on. All right. Because the Most High God is proving you every day. All right. You have something?
Yeah. I'm going to read it for you. I want you to break it down.
All right.
Wisdom of Solomon. Chapter 1:11.
Mm-hmm.
Therefore, beware of murmuring, which is unprofitable, and refrain your tongue from backbiting, for there is no word so secret that shall go for naught, and the mouth that belieth slayeth the soul. Seek not death in the error of your life.
All praises. Seek not death in the error of your life, because that's just like it's saying, Edges, don't let your sins weigh you down. All right, because you are going to come to a crossing roads, man, where you got to choose the Most High or you're going to choose death. See, read verse 12 again.
Verse 12. Seek not death in the era of your life.
Seek not death in the era of your life. Just because it gets hard, don't end it just because of one incident or because of 100 incidents.
Right.
All right. Do not seek death, because Sirach 4:3 said, do not add sorrowness. If your heart's already going this, hey, man, take a day off. You feel what I'm saying? Go shut yourself up and fast and pray to the Most High, all right? Give me 2 Ezra 14:14. All right, because that's to come a time when we make up in our mind that we're going to serve the Most High regardless of how hard it is, all right? Give me that.
2 Ezra 14:14.
Mm-hmm.
Let go from thee mortal thoughts. Cast away the burdens of man. Put off now the weak nature.
All right, because all it is weak nature. If you're giving in to those thoughts of the devil, that's weak nature. Read on.
And set aside the thoughts that are most heavy unto thee,
mm-hmm.
and haste thee to flee from these times.
Read on.
For yet greater evils than those which thou hast seen happen shall be done thereafter.
So that's why you got to put off the weak nature, because it's not going to get easier. Don't be complacent. If you dealt with this one thing, all right, you got over it, something harder is coming. So you have to gird up your loins, all right, and stand manfully to overcome these trials. Give me Deuteronomy 4:9, all right? So make sure you don't just listen to the video, watch the video. Make sure you take notes if this is something you're going through. All right, meditate on these scriptures. Read that.
Deuteronomy 4:9.
Mm-hmm.
Only take heed to thyself and keep thy soul diligently, lest thou forget the things which thine eyes have seen, and lest they depart from thy heart all the days of thy life.
All right.
But teach them thy sons and thy sons' sons.
All right, so don't forget these. Study these things so you can help the next man. Give me 1 Samuel 2:3.
1 Samuel 2:3. Talk no more so exceeding proudly. Let not arrogancy come out of your mouth. For the Lord is a God of knowledge, and by him actions are weighed.
All right, so are you going to overcome or are you going to call it quits? All right, you have that choice. Deuteronomy 30:15 says you got life or death. All right, with that, we say shalom.
Shalom.
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube channels. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.